Move on, Ollie boy!
Slow down, Mr. Drippy.
But Ding Dong Dell's just down the way.
Huh?
Hmm? Oh.
Huh? What do we do?
Run for it! Get going, shall we?
Huh? Hey, wait for me! So this is your world.
That's right. A whole nother world. Beautiful, innit?
Why, good morning, Oliver. Your groceries are over there, honey.
Thanks.
Oh, I almost forgot. Did Philip find you? He said he had something to show you, dear.
Really? So he finally finished it, huh? Do you know where he is right now?
He just stepped out with some deliveries for me. I doubt he'll have gotten far.
Thanks, Miss Layla.
Oh, say hi to your mother for me.
Sure thing.
Over here. Guess what? She's finally ready.
So what Miss Layla said? Is it really what I think it is?
What else would it be, dum-dum?
Boy, you are something else, Phil. So what do we do now?
What else? We take her for a spin. Tonight.
What? Tonight? But I can't. I mean, I need to ask my mom, and...
Sure, sure. You go ask your mom. And then when do we do it, huh? Tomorrow? Next year?
Well, I... No, but... Okay, we'll do it tonight, but we'll have to be real quiet.
Sure we will. Okay, tonight in my garage. Be there or be square.
Sure.
So, this is the child who will save the world.
Or so says the crystal ball, your radiance.
Hmm. The Dark Djinn's power alone will not suffice.
I fear not.
What is the child's name?
Oliver, your radiance.
Oliver?
Mom, I got the groceries.
Thanks, sweetie. Just pop them on the table, will you?
Say, Mom.
Did you say something, sweetie?
You're kind of busy tomorrow, huh?
Well, now that you mention it, I do have to practice for my concert in the morning.
Oh, yeah? So, you'll be in bed kind of early, huh?
Yes, I suppose I will.
Oh, you will, huh?
Will you stop being so mysterious and eat your breakfast? You'll be late for school. And chew before you swallow.
Thanks for breakfast, Mom. See you later, Mom.
Bye, sweetie. You be good now.
I will.
way! In here! What are you looking at? What is it with that kid? What kept you, Slowpoke?
Sorry, my mom just wouldn't go to bed. So, is it finished?
Sure is. The last bearing's in, and she's primed for action. Wanna see?
Do I ever?
All right. Here goes nothing.
Okay. Wow! Oh, is this neat, Phil? This is so, so neat!
You betcha.
It's so neat!
The new Coupe Deluxe ain't got nothing on us, Ollie.
It's not even close.
So, you ready to hit the road, kiddo?
Yeah! The coast is clear. I better go tell Phil.
Don't go!
What? Huh?
It's bad. Please, Oliver, don't go.
Huh? Who are you? How do you know my name?
Ollie! What's taking you so long?
I'm sorry, Phil. Someone saw me.
Oh, man. Who was it?
That girl of a... Huh?
What are you talking about? Huh? There's nobody there.
Huh. That's weird. She was right there. A girl.
A girl, huh?
Mm-hmm.
I bet it was that dumb, scary Mary. Oh no, couldn't be. She's not allowed out. You must be going screwy or something. Anyway, come on.
Okay.
Oliver, the boy who will save the world. But unfortunately for him, his light is yet a mere candle in the blackness.
Indeed. He may be the child the prophecies speak of, but he is a child nonetheless.
Yet these humans can be disturbingly powerful. Did the other's darkness not engulf the land entirely? Might this one not prove equally tenacious?
What would you have me do, Your Radiance?
Such saplings must not be suffered to grow.
Very well, Your Radiance.
He who would save this doomed world must die!
Sweetie? Where are you? Oliver? Oliver?
You're kind of busy tomorrow, huh?
Well, now that you mention it, I do have to practice for my concert in the morning.
Oh, yeah? So, you'll be in bed kind of early, huh?
Oliver! Oliver!
Did you listen to her prayer? Ready? Take it slow to start with, okay?
Yep, got it!
All right!
I'm so glad you're okay.
I'm sorry, Mom.
I'm sorry. I swear, if I'd known, I never would have.
Don't be silly, Phil. What about your car?
That hunk of junk? I can make another one in no time.
Well, I think you two have had quite enough excitement for one day.
Yes, ma'am.
Are you okay, Phil?
Must have twisted my ankle back there.
Whatever will you children get up to next?
Huh? Allie!
Allie?
Are you okay?
Mom? What's wrong?
Oh, my.
Mom? She always did have a weak heart.
Mom?
Oh, dear. I'll fetch the doctor.
Mom!
Oliver, sweetie. Oh, sweetie.
Mom?
You'll be okay. I know you will. Be good now. For me.
Mom? Mom? Mom! No. No! Don't leave me. You can't.
Sentimental fool. Sacrificing herself to save her child.
And yet, thanks to her, the boy lives.
Of course. But shorn of his mother's love, to whom can he now turn for guidance? And soon he will come to our world, where our powers are strongest.
Very good, your radiance.
Let us see how this story unfolds. I'm sure the ending will be engaging.
Oliver, honey, I brought you some apple pie. I'll just leave it here for you, okay, dearie? Just have to wait until dinner, Timmy told him. Oh, it's so sad. He's been in there 3 whole days now.
Oliver, Mummy starts her new job today, but She's asked someone very special to take care of you. Mummy spent a long time making him. I'm sure he'll look after you very well. Be good while Mummy's away, okay?
Mommy!
Is something wrong, sweetie?
Just come back soon, okay?
Of course, sweetie. We'll always be together, Oliver. Always. Always.
Mommy, come back. Please.
What's all this, Anna? Curse lifted, is it? Tiny! I'm free! Free!
Huh? What just happened?
You just witnessed the rebirth of Drippy, Lord High, Lord of the Fairies.
Who?
What, are you deaf or something? Drippy, Lord High, Lord of the Fairies, I said, didn't I?
Drippy?
That's right, and I'm sick to the teeth of you a snivelling and moaning. A proper crybaby bunting you are. 3 days, man. I mean, I've been sad before, but crying for 3 whole days? I'm surprised there's a drop of water left in you. You're a big boy, man. 3 days is, well, it's unheard of.
What?
Oh, dear, a bit flummoxed, are we? Bit lost for words. Not to worry, man. I got all the answers. Oh, but prepare yourself. Explaining all this is going to take a while. Ready?
Uh-huh.
Tidy. I like your style. Very honest, innit? Stay that way, okay? Take you far, I will. On with the show!
Okay.
See, it's like this, see? What it is there's more worlds out there than this one by you. There's what you might call parallel worlds, see? They're like worlds along by the side of your one. And one of those worlds is my world. That's right, a whole nother world.
Another world?
That's quick you are. And I, that is, the Lord High Lord of the Fairies, the reason I'm by her in this world of yours, well, it's because there's a proper bad apple trying to upset the peace of both our worlds, see? Shada, the Dark Djinn, his name is, and what he did was he took over people's hearts and spread war and ruin all over our world. Tried to stand up to him, I did, and he turned me into a flipping doll and kicked me out of our world and into yours, the rotter.
Uh-huh.
And then you went and cried all over me and poof, the curse was lifted, just like that. Which makes me think you must be the one we fairies call the pure-hearted one. The one the legends say will save our world. Just goes to show you can't judge a book by its cover, eh? So, anyway, that means I better get you over to our world and have you get rid of Shaddaa for us. All right with you?
Me? But how can I...
Don't fret, man. It's a big responsibility, I know, but you'll be all right. Especially with me to help you.
But I...
Oh, want me to ask properly, do you, fair dues?
What?
Oh, pure-hearted one, will you please come and save our world?
No.
Sorry, I must have misheard you. What did you say? Go on, once more, but louder.
I won't do it. I can't do it.
This is why they say never work with children. I ask nicely and you give me a hearty, yes, sir. That's how this works, see? Gee whiz, that would be swell, you say. It's just how these things are done. It's tradition. How am I supposed to work with this? It's like he's never read a story in his life.
But I don't know anything about your world. And I just can't right now.
What, because your mom dropped dead?
Yeah.
You got a photo of her? Hurry up, will you? I haven't got all day.
Okay.
Let's see now. Blimey. It can't be. But then it can't be a coincidence, neither.
What is it?
The great sage Alicia. Then we might just be able to save you, ma'am.
Huh? What are you talking about?
You ready for another UFO?
Yeah.
The souls of people in your world and my world are connected, which means people from over by you have another version of themselves over by there, called a soulmate, see? And people with soulmates can even look like each other. Now, your mam, well, she shared a soul with the great sage Alicia. A proper talent she was.
Huh? So my mom was a sage? But how does that help us save her?
Well, Alicia tried to take on the Dark Djinn, but his power was too much for her, and he trapped her in this dark jewel called the Soul Snare. When that happened, then the link between hers and your mam's souls would have been cut off. But if you could free Alicia, it just might fix the link, and who knows, it might even bring your mam back.
Is that really true?
I can't be sure now, but it's possible, yeah.
Wait. How do you know all this, Mr. Dribby? You've been a doll this whole time.
Ah, now there's clever of you. Good question, lad. It's like this, see? I'm not the only fairy. Even though I was stuck by you, my buddies were keeping me abreast of all the goings-on over there. How? I suppose it's what you might call telepathy. And that's not all. I was sending my lordly orders back over there too, having them spy on Shaddaa and that, you know, tidy, huh? Hmm? What is it?
I'll do it. I'll come to your world. I'll come with you and save my mom.
Oh, that's marvellous! You might be doing it for all the wrong reasons, but if it saves our world, I won't look a gift horse in the mouth. Tidy, we better get going then. Chop, chop.
Okay. But how do we get to your world?
Oh, curious, are we? All right, I'll tell you. First thing we need is a drop of magic. Go and have a dig around in the fireplace. There's something hidden there so nosy parkers won't find it.
But why would anybody hide something in there?
That's for me to know and you to find out. Look lively.
What could be hidden in a place like this?
A mighty spell book!
Huh? A book? But it would burn in there.
Not this book. The wizard's companion laughs in the face of fire. Wouldn't be much of a spell book if it didn't now, would it?
Really?
Aha! Gotcha!
This is a spell book?
That there is the wizard's companion, the fount of all wizarding knowledge.
The Wizard's Companion.
Tidy. Right, magic in our way over to my world, is it? Now let's see.
What is it?
You got a wand somewhere by here? We can't go casting spells without a wand now, can we?
A wand? Why would we have a wand?
Oh, that's a pain. Ah, well, can't be helped. We'll just have to look for one outside.
Huh? We won't find one out there either.
Don't nitpick, crybaby Bunting.
Bunting? My name is Oliver. Oliver.
Ah, so the crybaby bit was right, at least, was it?
Thank you. Thank you.